And furthermore, Susan, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised to learn that all four of them habitually smoke marijuana cigarettes. Reefers.
Use the tripod here. It's pretty nifty. The view we have is just stupid. This is the view we have. I don't know how well you can see the sun coming over. The green is incredible. This trail doesn't cease to blow me away. I just love it. Get around and show you the campsite here. This is incredible. Three eagles. The other side of this rock formation certainly does look like an eagle. Or water source down there.
This is spectacular.
This is one way to live, huh? It's not bad. That's home. This is where I live. This is not bad. Well, I don't know if you can tell at the moment. Oh, there. It gets pretty windy. Pretty windy. Yeah, it gets windy here on the PCT. it's a beautiful morning. It's brisk at the moment, but the sun is coming up and it warms things up rather nicely and quickly here in the desert. Even though it's still. The top daytime temperatures are gorgeous right now. It's perfect hiking weather. But, apparently Ant's tent is being my wind buffer today. And he's complaining about this because my tent is more made for the wind. It's true. The pole tents handle the wind. Freestanding tents handle the wind better. Other than the fact that you better make sure it's weighted down and staked down well or it'll fly away. The whole tent. I mean, it would go for miles here. Crazy. Ooh. I can feel the back of the tent lift up a little bit. Yeah, it's windy as hell. Let's check out the morning though. What's warm over there? Are you trying to convince yourself it's warm?
No, it's warm out. I'm in my bag.
Oh, I was gonna say it's not warm out. Okay, hold on.
I'm barefoot this morning. Ah,
the sunrise is gonna be spectacular. It's a good morning. It's a good morning. We have our supplies. We're taking care of it. Wait for the other guys. They didn't make it to the. Camp again last night. They only went about 8 miles, so we're taking easy.
We have 3 miles till town.
Yeah, we have 3 miles to town, and so we'll get there. And I think we're into zero tomorrow. Give me some time to upload videos and do some stuff. So. Oh, ooh, that weed gives me the hiccups. Yes. So it's a beautiful, gorgeous morning. We left. Where was that? Where were we yesterday? Started with like an M. You know, I'm so bad. Warren Road. Yeah, W. Warren Springs or something.
Warner Springs.
All right. So we got about a few miles out of Warner Springs yesterday. We've crossed the same stream here in the high desert like 4 times already today, but we've been able to rock up it. A little bit have to get creative in sections, but yeah. It's very reminiscent of the AT at the moment.
It is.
Yeah.
Flooded desert.
Flooded desert.
What's up?
Okay. It's
It's getting warm.
I feel like I'm a broken record. I get tired of saying how beautiful it is. It's the views around here. It's spectacular. It's hard to say, you know. There's a lot of talk, you know. People like to compare. People like to make one thing better than another. Talk about the AT versus the PCT or this and that. You know, I'm glad I did the AT first. It's definitely, so far, physically more grueling. The ups and downs are steeper. This is, the terrain is much better. There's views everywhere. The AT is, it beats you down and you have to, rise a... You can't let the... You can only beat yourself there. It's very mental. It's very internal. Out here, I don't understand how anyone gives up. This is incredible. But, you know, still have to get to the... There's a lot of trails still to go. So, you know, I guess it's unfair to judge at this point. But it's amazing. Well, don't really want to be taking a video right now. But I figure I should, just to show a thru-hike isn't all fun and games. It's, even in this constant beauty right now, you know, this is magnificent. The landscape is incredible. But I'm having a hard time today. I'm feeling the grind of it. I'm feeling the miles. I have to put in 16 miles. Gotta put in this many miles. And sometimes it gets to your head or gets to your body. Or I wasn't wearing my sock liner. And I got a little bit of blister on the back of my heel. Where's the trail? Oh, okay, here we go. Zigzag zamboozle on this trail. Yeah, I'm just... It's in a strange headspace. And, but it happens, you know. So aren't every day isn't gorgeous. Maybe things have been too good. You know, we have to have a little adversity in all ways. But what a gorgeous, beautiful day. I mean, I who knows? The last few miles might end up being immaculate. I might be able to get that gusto going. It comes in spurts right now. This is amazing scenery around here, though. Even though I must admit there's these new bushes that are quite pointy. The thorns are pretty fucking big. There wasn't enough pointy shit out here with the cactus. So now there's bushes that you have to barrel through that are 3-inch thorns on them. So shit likes to attack you out here in the desert. It's a harsh environment, that's for sure. It doesn't stop getting weird in the desert. Just, Mike's place. It's down the way here. It's definitely a vortex. We could definitely tell that. I don't know. I feel like a mad, crazy debauchery has occurred in this place. It's where the desert has forgotten. Where people just walk in from nowhere. No one notices the comings and goings. Yes, I don't know. It's time to leave. I'm a little scared of this vortex. Might enjoy it too much. But the views are amazing. I'm feeling much better. It's funny how that'll work. Your head... sometimes your head just gets in a bad space. And you just have to keep putting one foot in front of another. And, you know, sometime in the, usually within the day, you're feeling good again. And, God, I love being out here. So this is where we're camping for the night. Pretty epic spot. Very chill. I don't know.
aunt here says the moon's always out back home, but I always see it here for some reason. I don't know why. It seems strange to me. The Whitecap Mountains out in the distance. Whoa, shit is crazy out here.
Yeah,
we are gonna have to hike those. Yeah. So, but we're gonna do some cowboy camping, and Garfield strangely did not adequately
supply water,
so he is walking another 5 miles after walking 16 miles, because he needs water. So he said he was just gonna keep going. Meg is behind us somewhere. Hopefully he'll show up.
Stays at Mike's place or something.
Yeah, he'll be okay. He'll catch up to us.
One way or the other, he'll make the right call. He knows.
It's not his first rodeo.
I know.
Yeah, that's the interesting thing. Meg is he flip flopped, but he finished his thru-hike, and that's what's up. He plods along, but he makes it. Well, to another day.
Yeah.
So the hiker hunger is real. Right now, that's for sure. So, Aunt and I had some pasta with some cheese and Cheez-Its. We've already dug into this. And then the beef stroganoff. And then we added 2 packets of ramen. And, yes, the Cheez-Its. And the flavor is amazing.
This is a big package, well,
yes.
I think.
Yeah.
Not,
well, I mean, they claim it's for 2 servings. But, I mean, let's get real. Yes. Hiker hunger. 2 equals like 0.75. So.
Yeah, we're getting our calories in.
So, yeah, I got this out of a hiker box though. So, I can't afford that shit. Shit's off the chain though, isn't it?
That's why we put all the
Every single one of them's fucking good, man. Every single one of them.
And all the poor people food mixed in with it?
Yeah, the poor people food, that's the way you go. Like stretch it out. Stretch it out.
Calories and everything.
Exactly. All right. Now that's what's up.
Enjoy your. Oh, yeah, we're going to cowboy camp too.
Yeah, we already discussed that.
Yeah.
You are not eating chalupas. You lie. What are you eating over here?
I have Twix.
Ah, Twix. Yeah, we're having breakfast at Champions. He's having Twix. I'm having peanut M&Ms.
I had donuts earlier. I was at like 7:30.
You did have donuts earlier.
About 3 hours away.
Yeah, I mean, we're taking our time. Mega has not caught up to us yet. We were waiting for the, we cowboy camped, and there was some frost on top of the sleeping bags. Actually, just frost on top of ants. Mine's synthetic, so it didn't freeze. But he's drying out.
Yeah, it is dry.
Perfectly on this the California sun. So.
We have nothing but time to wait for our friends, so that's what we're doing.
That is what we're doing. No. But yeah, breakfast at Champions. Peanut M&Ms.
Not a bad meal.
No, not at all. The ongoing saga of the Mega. He is currently running away from us. We found him ahead of us on the trail somehow. So he has yellow blazed, blue blazed. So he did something where he passed us and didn't tell us. But now he does not want to. All he did was see us and begin running away. So he has implicated himself on whatever treachery he has done. So I've given him ample warning to give himself up. That we all know there's only one place you can go. It's the trail. We're all going the same place. He might as well give himself up now. While he said that was it was a tempting offer, he continues to elude. Not that we are pursuing too forcefully. We're just keeping a steady pace, so that way he tires himself out. All right, we'll let you know later on the continuing saga of the Mega Conspiracy.
Sleep on the porch.
We'll be about 8 miles away from there. I'm probably gonna be like.
I'll sleep in the dumpster. 14. Good morning, it's Mega Trash. I ate the leftovers.
Oh my god, that'd be great. We should do that. Eat their leftovers. I'm hungry.
Trans Pink Floyd, this is good stuff.
It actually is. I actually am quite enjoying it. Yes. Oh. What's going on here? Oh, okay.
Well, you're 5 miles of water. Hold on up the works over there.
I'm just about, I know, but my ankles are swelled.
I see these things on every trail. Okay, bands.
Oh, okay. Ant was going over the itinerary here. About 2.5 miles from Smoker's Bluff.
That's where home is going to be, at a water tap.
And then we get to home and roll two joints?
Yeah, yes? Yeah, we gotta make home first.
We have to make home first. Then roll two joints.
Yep.
Then eat, and then roll two more.
And okay, then, go to bed.
Then you go to bed. So that's the itinerary.
And we wake up early tomorrow and just kind of send it.
We do have to get up early.
It's an early day tomorrow.
It's for those that start in March, there is snow on top of some of the high elevations. So it's gonna be interesting here.
Interesting.
You know, we did moose lock and ice. I think we can handle a little bit of snow.
Next little section before Jacinto. Yeah.
We'll definitely need the micro spikes or crampons for. Yeah, well, we're not, unfortunately, we don't have the gear. The rest of us don't have the gear with us to do the climb up just into itself, which is a spur off of the PCT. We were going to, but it's we don't have the weather gear with us here, so we're gonna have to skip that. All right, so we're coming.
We're within a mile.
We're coming up on the Paradise Cafe. Apparently, we're coming upon civilization because we keep seeing lots of day hikers. We hear the burger is the way to go, but Ant had pancakes. We're in the mines, he said that hamburger with a side of flapjack. If available, and that gets the Stryder hiker trash seal of approval for sure. Yes. Oh yes, burger with a side of at least 3 or 4 flapjacks. Yes, yeah, with lots of butter and syrup, right? Ooh, yes. So, I don't know that they have flapjacks here, but we hear the burger is the way to go, and we are hungry as fuck. Are we gonna wait for Mega?
Yes.
We are going to be good, and we're going to starve, and we will.
We'll be waiting for another hour.
Yeah, we'll get high and wait for Mega.
Yeah.
All
right. The process of waiting for Mega.
The process, the ongoing saga of Mega continues. Yes, of course. He claims that he was not. He was not guilty of anything, that he was merely excited by seeing our presence and went skedaddling off. The story sounds fishy to me, but it is the story he is sticking to. So that is all I can say if you gave two flying fucks. So Feared, I'd show you the current conditions here in Idlewild. Bring the pow! That's right. It is snowing. We're not even anywhere near high elevation here. And it's, as you can see, Ant's tent is already starting to be buried. The bottom side of his rain fly. It's good insulation, though. I will attest to that. If you saw episode 1, you know that. Yeah, I spurred him to clean off the tent there. Ooh. Oh, you're a dirty girl. Yeah, so it's coming down heavy. Things have taken a bit of a turn. We're going to have to skip around San Jacinto entirely. I'm very disappointed about the situation, but I don't have crampons here or an ice axe here. I have a hippie that will be bringing those to me. She's delivering to me at Kennedy Meadows. So unfortunately, I won't be able to get it ahead of time, and neither does Mega. Ant doesn't have the crampons. Garfield has decided to buy crampons and an ice axe, and he's going to send it. And I encourage him to do so. I fully support him. But unfortunately, we're just going to have to skip this section. The weather report. The important one that everyone tells us about here for San Jacinto is sanjackjohn.com, and the weather's not good. The reports we have from people coming down is it is icy and hairy. There's a good 5 mile section of a ridgeline that there's just no way with the current gear that we have. We were ready for that in Sierras. We just weren't ready prepared for that this early in the season. Well, sun is starting to thaw things out, but as you can see here in Idlewild, it is a winter wonderland! Yay! Yeah.
Yay!
Yeah. What's today's date? March 21st. That's what I thought. So March 21st, and snow on the mountain. So, yeah, we don't have the mountaineering gear here. We have all that stuff. It's gonna be in Kennedy Meadows. So unfortunately, like I just talked about in the last. Who would like to say hello over there? Hey, how's it going? You get to be in a YouTube video now. Say hello to everyone on YouTube. All right. So there we go, guys. Snow on the mountain.